name is Colleen Williams, and I'm a Senior Program Manager on the Microsoft Edge team, and I'm here to talk with you about the state of the browser in 2020. When it comes to the browser, we know there hasn't been a perfect solution. In fact, you likely use two browsers throughout your day, i.e. for legacy dependencies and a modern browser for everything else. 60% of organizations have legacy browser dependencies. We have them here at Microsoft as well. And when you look at these legacy sites, it's really hard to justify rebuilding them in modern standards because they just need to work. One of the main concerns when working on browsers is the potential for a security breach. So browsers remain a vulnerable surface for bad actors to access the corporate network, information, and data. In addition, end users can click on something, download something, save something. It's very easy to talk an end user into doing something inadvertently. The average cost of a data breach is close to $3.9 million. So security issues keep a lot of us up at night. I don't know about you, but I do spend a lot of time in the browser, not just because I work on one, but 60% of time spent using a browser on a PC from our telemetry. It is the number one used application in an OS, so it better be good. And finally, everyone has had to adjust to remote work almost overnight. Forrester anticipates that up to 50% of an organization's workforce may stay permanently remote. So Edge plays a very important role in this shift. This video will show why Edge is the browser for business, the browser in a remote environment, what we've been working on over the last year, and what's coming. So what is needed from a browser? Edge took the opportunity to focus on unique business needs. We've spoken with many, many customers, and it is important that a browser respects and maximizes existing investments across the organization. It's also very important that the end user and developer love the browser. It doesn't do us any good to build software that increases your support costs. So we think about the browser in the following ways. Protect with confidence. Edge is built with native Microsoft security features developed over years of working directly with enterprise customers. One such feature led Edge to top recent reports as the highest rated browser in phishing and malware protection. With features like this, you can protect your organization's users and data with confidence. Manage the browser. Every IT admin we speak with talk about the importance of being able to manage the browser. They have voiced frustration over needing two browsers, i.e. 11 for legacy applications and websites, and a modern browser for everything else. The new Edge can run legacy sites and apps and modern sites all in one browser. You can also manage Edge with the tools that you already use, such as Microsoft Endpoint Manager. And last here, end user and developer appeal. Edge also empowers productivity, giving users tools to find data, use it, and use the corporate information they need faster. The ability to remain efficient and productive throughout a workday is essential. And in 2020, we learned to think of these three things all together and all at once. So while we aren't physically located in a corporate-owned office or on a corporate-owned device, we need to be able to be efficient and productive while working from our dining room tables and keeping our personal and work lives separate. So over the last few months, we've done quite a bit of research, and our Microsoft research team has gone out to talk to IT admins and end users to talk about pain points. So from the IT pain point perspective, they've had to shift focus to help workers remain productive in the new environment, maintain business continuity, manage network and connectivity issues, enable access to remote resources. And a lot of these resources didn't exist prior to March of 2020. It's as simple as, how do I VPN in? How do I access work data resources? And so a lot of us have had to start from scratch. And in doing so, we have to ensure that there's high security standards to protect corporate data and information at all times. From an end user standpoint, the pain points, and I think we can all relate to this as we are all end users at the end of the day. So how to separate work and personal lives, how to remain productive in their new home environments, access corporate information safely, work around poor internet connectivity, and adapt to a new work culture. And we've had to do this all while being isolated or having to fit in children's education and or taking care of other family members. So moving along, we've got security and compliance, which helps keep the browser secure, corporate data and information, manageability and productivity. So Edge is the most holistic browser for M365 customers, enabling you to harness the power of your investment. And finally, With most of us having to work remote seemingly overnight, Edge has shown it is the right browser for the remote environment. This presentation will show you all of the features Edge had built in prior to 2020 and new features we've prioritized to make working from anywhere simpler. So just a quick recap. So we announced that we were moving to the Chromium open source project in December of 2018. And all of 2019, we spent releasing previews, including our Canary, Dev and beta channels, along with a Microsoft Edge version that supported macOS. January of this year, we released our stable channel for broad availability, and we've been updating every 6 weeks since then. In August, we announced our Fast Track partner program. So for those of you familiar with Fast Track and the partner program, Edge is now a part of that. And what we're continuing to do is listen and learn. So all of the features that I'm going to talk about that we are doing and have done over the last year is all based upon feedback we've received from you. So let's start with security and compliance. So if we take a look at this slide, it covers things that we talked about at Ignite last year, such as smart screen, application guard, conditional access, and tracking prevention. I'm going to go into detail of the things that we've done since Ignite last year, and then what we're working on for the future. And again, as talked about, these features with the home icon right next to them, those are features that we already had that help and benefit remote work and makes that super simple for you. So let's go into detail into what's new since Ignite last year. So smart screen. Smart screen protects from social engineering designed to trick users. As I said earlier, it's very easy to talk a user into doing something. So smart screen helps protect with malware, phishing, drive-by exploits. And a new feature that we've added is potentially unwanted apps. Since smart screen works based upon reputation, this has flagged that this is a potentially unwanted app. So it's reported that the app has a low reputation or might cause unexpected behaviors. So you can take a look and move through what you need to do there. Report the app as reputable, keep, or you can go ahead and cancel out so you don't have to download that app that you're not familiar with. So in 2020, the NSS Labs conducted an independent test of phishing and malware on the top four browsers with hundreds of thousands of phishing and malware samples over a course of a few weeks. So you can see here what they've tested. So measurements of protection against fresh new attacks, consistency of protection over time, and how effective the browser protection was overall. And here are some results directly from their study. So Edge offered the most protection, blocking 98.5% of malware while providing the highest zero-hour protection rate. And the next one regarding phishing, Edge offered the most protection, blocking 95.5% of phishing URLs while providing the highest zero-hour protection rate at 89.2%. And you can take a look at these results on nsslabs.com. So browser isolation, application guard and latest updates. So browser isolation is a cybersecurity model which aims to physically isolate an internet user's browsing activity. So we've been working hard on application guard feature support based on feedback we've gotten from customers. Application guard extension support. So app guard isolates untrusted sites to separate containers. Extensions has been a top piece of feedback from customers. Scenarios range from ad blockers or running your favorite extensions, but you want to utilize the security and safety of AppGuard, and that has been available since Edge version 81. Traffic identification. So some enterprise customers are deploying AppGuard with a specific use case where they need to identify web traffic coming out of AppGuard container at the proxy level. So starting with version 84, Edge supports dual proxy to address this requirement, and you can see that in the pictorial here on the right. So Application Guard, diagnostic page for troubleshooting. So another user pain point is troubleshooting AppGuard. So Edge now has a diagnostics page to troubleshoot any user issues. One of these diagnostics is being able to check the URL trust based on the configuration of the user's device, and that is now available. As Satya spoke about at Inspire, about endpoint data loss prevention, this feature helps businesses identify and protect corporate info across all access points. So it's the first browser to natively support endpoint DLP without any plugins. Seamless integration. Requires E5. The public preview is available and GA is coming soon. And this is a new feature that we've prioritized due to 2020 and helping with the remote environment. Endpoint data loss prevention. So with the emphasis of working from anywhere, customers need a way to manage applications on personal devices. So we want to be able to allow end users to use personal devices while keeping corporate information and data secure. So this is DLP via modern app management. This is something that we are working on, a new feature that we have prioritized based upon 2020, and this is part of our roadmap. And Windows Information Protection helps protect enterprise data from unauthorized accidental disclosure. So this helps with any risk with personal and work activities occurring on corporate devices. We also prioritized this, and this shipped earlier than expected in the March timeframe. Let's move on to manageability. So last year we spoke about IE mode as well as mem support and group policy. We've done quite a bit of work since that timeframe, improved IE mode diagnostics based upon customer feedback, version pinning and Intune. We've added additional group policies with the release of Windows Virtual Desktop. Edge is supported on WVD, and we've released our security baselines. Those features with the home icons there, those are features that contribute to remote work. And so what we're going to focus on is what we are working on next. So IE mode, one of the things that we continue to hear from customers is an easier way to manage the enterprise mode site list for IE mode. A cloud solution versus an XML file. So here you can see we are working on just that. We are moving the site list management into the M365 admin center. This allows for the IT admin to create, edit, and manage the site list, as well as publish the site list to a secure location in the cloud. Kiosk mode, it's in preview available today, can be invoked through the command line on Windows 10. We have quite a few kiosk modes available, full screen and public browsing and private navigation, reset user session on inactivity, initial set of lockdown functionalities, and more to come. And so this is available on the Windows 10 Insider Preview on our Edge dev channel. Targeting later this year is general availability of Edge kiosk mode support without assigned access. And coming in 2021 is GA of Edge kiosk mode with assigned access to a single app. Additional features and parity compared with our legacy Microsoft Edge, and integration with Intune to configure devices for these scenarios. More information on our documentation here on the right. We've been working with our partners in Intune, and this work goes hand in hand with the ability to manage applications on unmanaged devices while preventing any data loss. So what is app configuration for Edge? For IT, app configuration allows IT admins to apply settings and policies, which would take effect anytime the user associated with that account with a profile, all without the device needing to be managed. And then for the end user, app config enables a consistent experience for them using Edge for work, regardless of what device they are using, and without those settings changing their traditional browsing experience, and without IT controlling broader aspects of the device. So IT will control the parts of the device that the user needs to access corporate information, but doesn't control the rest of the device. So this is a new feature that we are working on to help with the remote work, and we're partnering with Intune. How do you set up app config in Intune? So this is very similar to setting MDM policies from the Intune portal. And for your users, the next time they use Edge with a profile containing the authorized account, the settings will be applied to the browser whenever the user is browsing using that profile. One of our biggest pieces of feedback that we've received since we started talking with customers about the new Microsoft Edge is the ability to roll back versions. So what is rollback? So this allows IT admins to easily downgrade to a known compatible version while minimizing any interruption to users. So you're on version 86, you go to 87, you realize something is incompatible, a line of business application that you need, you can roll back to version 86, a known version that allows you to continue to work while the compatibility issues get worked through. So how does it work? You downgrade the application, it clears user data, restores snapshot if available, and sync if enabled restores user data from the cloud, and this is coming soon. Productivity, end user and developer appeal. This is a great topic because we are all users of the browser, and whether you're using it for personal or work, we all need to remain productive and efficient. So you can see on the left here all of the features that we talked about last year at Ignite, a ton of features that we have been working on since then, and then what we're working on in the future. These icons show these features that address the end user pain points that we discussed earlier, specifically the ability to keep personal and work lives separate, being able to find corporate information fast and efficiently. And we're going to focus on what we've been doing since Ignite. And what I don't want to get lost is the developer aspect, both Linux and WebView. And so we'll discuss that as well. So automatic profile switching. Automatic profile switching helps you get to your work content more easily while using multiple profiles. When you're using a personal profile and navigate to a work site, it will prompt you to switch to your work profile to access that site without having to authenticate. When you choose the work profile you want to switch to, the website will simply open in your work profile. Microsoft Search and Bing, sidebar search, a new feature that's added on top of Microsoft Search and Bing. So if you remember, this allows you to search your corporate information right there in one spot. The results are personalized for you and your work and are available through Bing, not shared with Bing, powered via the Microsoft Graph. So with the sidebar search, it helps you do quick lookups without losing context. So you can quickly search words or phrases from a web page. Search results will show up in a pane on the side of the web page, and workplace results will appear if you are signed in with your Azure Active Directory account. Another feature for Microsoft Search and Bing is the work page, so a better way to find info at work. So you can see here Daisy Phillips. She's got her information, all of her title, who she reports to. So this is dedicated space. So only results from your company appear here. You'll never see web results. So if there is a Daisy Phillips on the broader web, but you are looking for your colleague Daisy Phillips, this is what you're going to see. It's easier to scan. A larger set of work results means fewer searches to find what you need. And then, of course, filter and find. So narrow your results to people, groups, sites, files, or conversations, as you can see here on the left side. Enterprise new tab page. So we have a new experience coming. This is a blended experience with Office 365. You see more than just Office 365. You see a My Feed, personalized LinkedIn news, and business news. So you can do even more with the Enterprise new tab page. If we moved into the personalized area, you can see all of the different areas that you can mark, and these will show up in your feed. So this is coming at a later time. Collections plus OneNote. So Collections is expanding Office 365 integrations to help customers use the content you find online. So you can now send your collection to OneNote, choose which notebook and section to add it to, and a new page will appear with your content. Immersive Reader. So this is native to Edge, makes reading online easier and more accessible for everyone. Reading is one of the most common activities you can do on the web, but it can be difficult for people with learning disabilities. Clicking on Immersive Reader icon removes distractions on the screen and creates a simplified environment that helps you focus. Immersive Reader is available, including new features like line focus, translate support, and picture dictionary. And let's not forget about mobile. So work wherever and whenever you want. Edge is available on mobile, both iOS and Android, and we have a ton of features that helps you have a similar experience regardless of device. So Azure Active Directory, conditional access, multiple profiles, sync, Microsoft Search and Bing, all of these features are available via mobile as well. So Edge on Linux. Since we first announced Edge, we talked about our desire to not have any fragmentation across platforms. And Linux has been a top piece of feedback from literally everyone we've spoken to. Where is Edge on Linux? So we know that millions of web developers call Linux home, and we want to make sure that any dependency or test automation, and we want to make sure Edge is a part of that. So we've previously shared our desire to bring Edge to Linux, and I'm excited to share that we've recently begun our Linux journey and plan to begin publishing dev channel builds of Microsoft Edge for Linux. And you can see that October 2020 date for that. WebView 2, this is based on Microsoft Edge on Chromium, consistent across supported Windows versions. It is available for Win32, C, C++, and some other areas. The default is Evergreen, or if you want a fixed version, that is available as well. And before we wrap up here, I want to take the opportunity for a couple of reminders. We did recently make two announcements. The first announcement is M365 web apps won't be supported on IE11 as of August 17th, 2021. Teams will end support a bit earlier on November 30th. We also announced that Microsoft Edge Legacy Desktop will be deprecated on all versions of Windows 10 on March 9th, 2021. In this Microsoft Tech Community article, here below explains all of these announcements and the dates. But what I want to make sure you understand is there's no confusion, because some of our web properties are not going to support IE in the 2021 timeframe. That doesn't mean that IE 11 is going anywhere. It is still a part of the OS and has continued to be supported on the lifecycle of the OS on which it is installed. And one of our differentiating factors from other companies is our ability for support at no additional cost. So we've got the Aperture program. So if a site works on IE 11 standalone on Google Chrome or any version of Edge, they'll also work on the new Edge, and if not, give us a call. For Fast Track, for customers who have deployed 150 plus seats of Windows 10 Enterprise, the Fast Track program is there and has added Edge as a part of their support. And the beta and the stable channels are available through our Premier Support program. Thank you. That is my enterprise story for Edge. So a couple of things for you to go do. Make sure you are downloading Edge. set it as your default browser. We have a lot of documentation on ak.ms/deploy-edge. This is where you can plan, deploy, configure, manage, and learn about all of the enterprise features that I discussed here today. And we have more videos available on our Edge YouTube channel, so please make sure to go check out deeper dives into all of the features that I talked about. Thank you so much for your time. I hope this presentation was enjoyable, and have a great rest of Ignite.